We're on a mission to find out whether Bentley's first ever performance 4x4 SUV, the £165,000 Bentayga, can beat an established giant of the sector, the £100,000 Range Rover Sport SVR, and give the discerning customer the best of all worlds.
The Range Rover nudged it in round one, as all the brand's off-road experience came into play.
But the Bentley fought back on the tarmac, leaning on all its years in the luxury sector.
So that leaves one area left to test: sportiness.
This is my highlight of the dogfight, to see how they put their power down.
Yeah, because this is the bit where you get to throw me around a track. Always happens after lunch. In these, which are essentially opulent drawing rooms on wheels.
Although both weigh well over 2 tonnes, they have big power to compensate. The Range Rover has 575 horsepower and the Bentley 606. And that's why both have 0 to 62 times that would beat a Porsche 911 Carrera.
But impressive statistics are one thing. Delivering in the real world is another.
You got your stopwatch ready?
Oh, yeah.
Here. Right, in.
That's a proper old school one.
Our test facility is the Landau circuit, which comprises some long flowing bends and some tight twisty sections to check if these machines possess a sports car-like agility. The laps are timed from a standing start. You ready?
Yeah.
Got your starting position?
Yeah, this is my starting position, Vicky.
Okay, go. Oh! Struth, that was a bit noisy, wasn't
it? Exhaust is part of the sort of dynamic mode.
Do you know what's ridiculous? Is that noise is too loud for the speed.
Way too loud. It's so overt compared to any jag. Listen to it cackling and popping.
It does feel, though, that the noise should belong to, like, aeroplane or something, not a car.
Well, that's one of the things about the SVR, is it's unashamed.
SVR stands for Special Vehicle Racing and is Land Rover and Jaguar's tuning division, like AMG for Mercedes and M Sport for BMW. So it's clear this Range Rover has serious sporting intent. Though I'm not sure Vicky would agree right now.
Whoa, 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 Vicky. This is a big car for a small track.
There is no feedback from the front end whatsoever. I almost do not know what the front tyres are doing. It's not telling me anything. I think this is just a point and squirt, Johnny. I think just turn the wheel, put the throttle down and just hang on, I think.
Oh, crumbs.
Understeer. There's absolute zero feedback from any, from my legs, my feet, my hands.
Okay. All right,
oh, my lordy lord.
Can I say this now that I'm at your mercy?
Yeah.
I just have no interest in cars like this. I just cannot understand why they exist. I mean, it's such a big slab.
You ready on that stopwatch? You had enough?
I'm all right.
The Range Rover posts a time of 58.55 seconds. Can the Bentley do any better?
I want to know
what
it feels like to go around a tight track in a 2.4-tonne, 187-mile-an-hour war room.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Whoa. I'm going for the grab paddle straight
away. Both of their accelerations from the off is phenomenal, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
It's proper stuff.
Oh, I'll tell you what, I've just realised I can adjust my headrest with these little wings. I'm going to need it in a minute.
The Bentley has 30 extra horsepower, but weighs 130 kilograms more, so both cars have absolutely identical power-to-weight ratios.
I have to say, the body roll is less in this car, from what I can tell immediately. It is loud.
It's nowhere
not
near
as
loud.
It's not as overtly silly.
This feels much more stable. The body control on this is superior.
It
markedly
is,
so, yeah.
Ooh, that's a hairpin. Oh, that'll be understeer. Oh, hello.
Wow, you can have a bit of fun.
This has surprised me. I thought the SVR would be the superior track tool.
I am really shocked, actually.
Yeah.
That suspension setup, that electric
active anti-roll system. Well, it's 48 volts, super fast motors pumping up each side to eliminate that body roll. It's doing a fine job. Oh. I have to say, it's incredible.
This is amazing. I'm really, really impressed.
I mean, and I like being in here because then I don't have to look at it on the outside.
I'm actually getting more feedback as well. I mean, not a huge amount, but the car is telling me a bit more about what's going on underneath. The brakes, though, aren't quite as sharp as they are in the Range Rover, and you are really feeling that 2.4 tonnage.
You can't hide definitely. It.
But you can hide it around the corners. Look at this.
Whoa, slippery. Well, Vicky,
what was the time then?
I can taste my jagged potato and coleslaw. I really can.
The Bentayga crosses the line in 59.06 seconds. That's half a second slower than the SVR. But in these changeable conditions, it's clear there's virtually nothing to separate them.
So they're very, very similar. But
the behaviour is very different.
Very different. I would buy this car because it is not ashamed of being a luxurious, expensive, outrageous SUV.
Yep.
And for that, I got to salute it.
As for me, I wouldn't choose either. For that sort of budget, I'd buy a dedicated sports saloon and a dedicated off-roader. But I will tell you this, at his first attempt, Bentley has built something on a par with the Range Rover, a badge which pretty much created this sector. And that is remarkable, although they did need a £165,000 price tag to do so.